I must admit, my team look freaking awesome. I mean, we have a Turian, a Quarian, and a motherfucking human. Hello everyone, this is Norite and welcome for some more Mars Effect. Last time, we proved that the Saren is guilty. We now a Spectre, and we completed some requests on this damn amazingly giant ship. So, what I have in my mind? Let's explore a little bit more. Well, you want... you can just go and explore the entire universe just right away, but... what fun in that? You need to do everything that you can do. And also, we need to find as many keepers as possible, because every single one of them give us money and free experience. The higher your level, the more experience and money you will get from this. And by the way, before I forgot, I actually done something that I didn't know exist. So you're probably aware of my of a history of the main character. So you're probably aware of the history of the main character. Yeah, he is an he lives on a fleet, changes his ship because he both of his parents work in the military, and at the same time, wait, we covered before that.
Dancers are highly respected among my people, but I get the feeling these women are not held in high esteem.
You're damn right, Talia. Tali, what the heck are you saying? His name is Tali. Bleh. Anyway. So as it turns out, every single history of that are able to be chosen decide the fact about which reputation you gotta have most. I gonna put this on the screen probably, and you will see just right now. Here it is. I will try to not forget to do this. It will be really embarrassing if I tried, if I said about this and for some reason it's up, it's gone. No, okay. You know, the stuff. So yeah, every single one of your decision during the creation of a character give you 3 points of Paragon and Renegade. And both of them are pretty damn good. For example, if I was a military, if I was from the fleet, but at the same time I was ruthless during my military years, I would get a good amount of points. Ah, it's not active yet. Yeah, so there's gonna be another mission. So yeah, decide for yourself what your backstory is gonna be, but be aware that you will get 3 points. Reputation points for each one. Or maybe not reputation, maybe it's more like no, it's more reputation. It's not deciding your morals by any means. No, heck no. It decides who you are by the thoughts of the people and what you can do with that. So if you're ruthless, people will know that, and because of that you can threaten them. They will afraid of you.
Hey, I know you. You're Shepard, right? I was on Mindwar during the Blitz, saw you on the vids when you got your medal. You saved the whole colony.
Looks like you have a fan.
I'm sorry, I just never thought I'd meet someone like you in person. My name's Lang, Officer Eddie Lang, Citadel Security. It's an honor to meet you, Commander. What are you doing down here in the wards? Anything I can help you with?
Oh, this guy is just another information dispenser. We already know about everything.
See you around, Commander.
So let's go to the CSEC Academy. CSEC is pretty much the police of the Citadel, as much as I am aware. They're ready to do a military... Ah, for fuck's sake. They're ready for the military work, but they usually not do it. You'll see later in the game that they're actually capable of doing shit. That's awkward.
Do you ever regret leaving Citadel Security to pursue Saren, Garrus?
He not even left the Citadel yet.
Spectre with countless lives at stake and no regulations to get in the way, I'd say that beats CSEC.
I'm pleased that the imminent destruction of all organic life has improved your career opportunities.
I just like how even in face of destruction and death, those people always gonna be snarky. I just love the characters in this game. They're all so amazing, even the bad ones. Even Vega in third game is amazing character. It's really, it's pretty much Mass Effect is a Star Wars of video games. It's amazingly done. And you can't deny the fact that this is one of the best games ever made. So yeah, this place is really interesting.
One sec, looking you up. Commander Shepard, here with the Alliance military. First time on the Citadel, that about right?
Sure is.
How did you know all that?
I'm the CSEC requisitions officer. I need to make sure our buyers are authorized. So, will you be purchasing anything today, Commander Shepard?
Sorry about that. Yes, I will.
Show me what you've got.
Sounds good. Just let me set you up. Well, this must be a mistake. System's telling me to offer you our select stock. Spectre. Well, I heard about that, but I didn't realize it was you. Sorry, Commander.
No problem.
Just show me what you've got.
I'll open the rare stocks for you, Commander. Enjoy.
So yeah, being a Spectre gives you the best weapon there is. It's mostly better than you are gonna buy in normal stores, but it's all damn expensive, as you can probably see. That's actually a pretty good buy. And a license. License will allow you to buy equipment at your ship. Nikolai Shepard, this gun is amazing. I just want it. I want it really, really bad. This pistol also amazing. I mean, look at that. Strider 2 is nothing compared to HMVP 7. I want all of this weapon, but I cannot buy it just yet. There is a way to get money real quick, real fast. It's by gambling a lot and freaking... how do you call this? Saves coming? Yeah, I think it's called safe scamming, but it's just not my way, and it's really boring. Just play the game, lose all the money, reload. It's not interesting. So, where do we need to go? To Presidium. It's lower worlds. You know, we complete the mission for Shaira. Let's go to Shaira. We unlock all everything. Good. So, console chambers. By the way, I just like this stock image. I just look at it and think, oh my god, it's such a perfect... Oh no, we need to go to the embassy first. I forgot about that. Presidium location. Embassies. I'm pretty aware that we missed some. I'm pretty damn aware that we missed some locations. Some of the locations will close to you for later, to be opened late in the game, but right now it's simple as all hell. So let's go to the Elcor embassy and talk with our friend Elcor over here. Hey, Xelton!
Strange greeting, human. This is really not a good time.
I know who revealed your secret. It was a Turian named Septimus.
Unbelieving. I know this Septimus, and he could not learn my secrets. The only way he could learn them is from the Asari consort.
Here, this should be proof enough for you.
Confused. This is difficult to fathom. If the Turian could learn this on his own, dismayed. Anyone can discover my secret.
You'll be fine.
Septimus is a powerful man, and it wasn't easy for him to find.
Relieved. I suppose you are correct, human. Thank you for this information. Startled realization. I must speak with the consort. She will be most displeased with my actions. Anxious request. Please, human. If you will excuse me, I must go now.
I'm sure she'll forgive you. It was an honest mistake.
Doubtful. Perhaps you are right, human. I can only hope so. Thankful. That was a great thing you did, Commander. Approving. You see, Din, not all humans are as you say.
I'm sure the Earth Clan stands to profit from this in some way.
Oh, shut up. As much as I love Voluses, I freaking... Yeah, they're freaking funny and I like them in multiplayer in the third game. But let's be honest, Voluses is one of the worst races to deal with. Imagine, like, the entire race that's based on bargaining and selling and restocking. It's like America the planet. I would be freaking hating that place. Okay, I'm not hating America. I like the people of America. I love their culture. I just really hate the government and the economical system, because let's be honest, it's based on pain of the others. This is practically what capitalism is all about. And before I say it's not, I am the guy who work, who... Okay, here we have X.
So they finally did it. I knew one of your kind would make Spectre one day. I only hope you're better than the one they're sending you after.
I'll do everything I can to stop Saren.
That's what worries me. Was there something you wanted?
Nah.
I'll be going now.
Goodbye.
Oh no, we can speak with him about an instigation.
Yeah, what can I do for you now?
Oh, he, we can already speak about it because we solved that instigation, but I thought we can, like, learn about it a little bit more.
This place seems strange. There's no more humans around.
I don't have time to talk now.
Oh, so she's not giving me mission just yet. Before you ask, I just love to explore the Citadel because it's one of the best places in the entire game. It's so big and so much to do, so much to see, so much wrong with taking a backseat, you know. Just like Smash Mouth used to say, because they don't sing anymore. Which is really sad, because actually, the song is not bad, it just become really memeing. Really meme, let's just say. And it's not the fault of Smash Mouth, it's just people. People can be assholes and will be assholes. And you need to deal with that. It's a sad but honest truth. So it's CSEC Academy. So where should I go? I remember that I missed something. Because I remember that on this stage you can do something more. Yeah, we need to go to Shaira. What the heck am I talking about? So go upstairs. Hello NPC, nice to see you. Hello another NPC. Nepesi. This word for some reason sounds really familiar. And we also need to visit a store which on... yeah. That's... so let's go there. I think there is not that much to do. We check that keeper, yep. Keepers is a... also in its degrees. You can probably look up in wiki for this game, but... keepers isn't a race. They're practically a bio-machine. They just do whatever they were told during their creation, and nobody know who created them. Ah, there's still nothing.
Ah, human. This one is greatly pleased to see you here in my decadent emporium.
Who are you?
This one's face name is Delaninder.
Delaninder!
Refer to it as Delan.
Delan!
Please take time to examine the fine goods it has for purchase, all of great worth.
Why do you refer to yourself as this one, it?
For the same reason that humans are so inquisitive. It is part of our culture. Specifically, Hanar only refer to themselves in the first person with family or intimates. And we rarely do so with other species. It is just our way.
It just hit me. This is fucking Japanese culture. Like, you know that Japanese is overly polite. Like, they... Like, this one is, you know... Hanar is... Okay, this is racist. Why are they jellyfish and they... Okay. It just hit me. Okay, goods.
What exactly do you sell?
Only the finest and most luxurious items that credits can buy. This one is able to procure almost any item the human would desire. For a price, naturally.
I'd like to see these rare and wonderful items.
Oh, this one is pleased to do so, human. You will not be disappointed.
So yeah, here you can buy a non-human armor. This is practically Turian. And Quarian and Krogan and stuff. Right now there is not much to buy.
Commander.
Show me your items.
Oh, this one is bleed.
So here we can shotgun. Holy shit, Firestorm is so much better. But we cannot buy. So let's buy the license. It's better to buy a license beforehand, because you can later, if you need to restock or buy a new weapon, you just can't go on the you just can't buy this on the ship. Yep. You need oh, here is Helena Blake. Oh, her mission is probably the worst to deal with, because it's like, okay, you...
Hello, Spectre. I have a business proposition for you.
How did you know I'm a Spectre?
Word travels. Your name comes up in certain circles. I'm acquainted with a pair of powerful crime bosses. They're hiding on remote worlds, and I have the coordinates. You could do the galaxy a favor.
What kind of defenses would these two have?
I haven't the faintest idea, but they're certain to be armed.
As usual for criminals to be.
Their partnership soured, and each believes that the other intends to kill him. They will be well prepared.
I eliminate them, and then you take over and try to eliminate me. How stupid do I look?
While I appreciate your estimation of my bravado, I have no intention of attempting to murder you. You are the first human Spectre, and you are doing important work for humanity. I have no interest in Red Sand or slavery. Anyone who does deserves to die. Our needs are aligned.
What's Curtis?
What do you get out of this?
We share interests in certain cooperative ventures, but their business practices have forced me to terminate our relationship. Once they are dead, I will manage our organization in a more tasteful manner.
What crimes did these men commit?
They're Red Sand dealers who make victims of their customers. Those who can no longer pay are sold to Batarians as slaves. They're loathsome, hurting innocent people. They must be ended.
Not a problem.
If they're as bad as you say they are, they need to be dealt with.
Excellent. Here are the coordinates. When these men are dead, I will wait for you at the third set of coordinates. Goodbye, Commander. It's been a pleasure to meet you.
I will get the... Renegade. But before you say something like, oh, you said you're gonna be Paragon. Okay. I do Renegade choices sometimes as long as I want to look badass and awesome. And this probably was a badass choice, because after all, this asshole deserve to be freaking dealt with. So, here's the Sharira. We have to tell you that no, Elcor is not charging her anymore. And that Septimus is no longer will be a giant ass douchebag.
Commander, I recently received a lovely note from Septimus. Thank you for speaking with him. Even the Elcor diplomat has withdrawn his campaign against me.
Glad to help.
It was my honor to aid you.
You are too kind, Commander. But I would not expect you to help me out of the kindness of your heart. I also have one more thing to give you, if you are interested.
Of course.
I'd be honored.
I offer a gift of words, an affirmation of who you are and who you will become. I see you. Your uniform fits as though you were born wearing it. You are a soldier through and through, proud, solitary, alone. But it gives you strength. It is that strength that people are drawn to. It is why you lead and others follow without question. You will need that leadership in the battles to come. This may be who you are, but it is not who you will become. It only forms the basis for your future greatness. Remember these words when...
So, this is practically what I told you about making history for our character. This is what it led to.
You have quite a gift, Chihira.
Thank you. Not everyone appreciates it as you do. Never underestimate the power of words. Here, Commander. In light of your efforts with the Alcor Ambassador, I would like you to have this small trinket.
What is it?
A small mystery. I have never learned its use or purpose, but I sense it is time for me to pass it on. And now I must ask you to leave. I have done everything I can for you.
It's good. Thank you for the trinket, and I get a Paragon, Paragon points. Good. Now I think we've done everything, we can go now. No, I just remember one thing. Oh, no, we need to go to the wards. Markets. Yeah, I think we can get her from markets, I think. I can't quite remember it. Okay, here we are. This is upper markets. And this way is down markets. And here we have another store which we need to buy a freaking form in. Okay.
Hello there. Welcome to Moreland's famous shop. You want many good supplies, yes?
Let me see what you have.
Oh, you will be pleased, I think. Very good things I have. You will see.
By the way, you cannot... That's actually good. Having more metagel on you, it's a pretty good thing. Here's Krogan's, by the way. Good, good. Now I know who I need to beat up if something will go wrong. Ship. So it is in the fist office. Let's go over there. Over there! It's not here, Superman. If the problem is over there, it's not over. Okay, I just remember that idiotic comic which I read. Like, sometimes I talk with people who reading comics and I like say, oh, you need to read this, you need to read that, and they send me the copy of this stupid Superman. Free money! How can I deny that? Take it all! So yeah, we collect the... So, what do we have in our journal? Oh no, it's Codex. Journal, here it is. Hostile takeover, Citadel the Fan. Yeah, Conan Brennan, I know about him. Oh yeah, it's for M and Ada Wong, and this is how many keepers we need to... And this is space mission? Space mission! And I'm sorry. Many of this mission is pretty much useless. No, they're not useless. They actually make appearance in the future events. But as a story, they don't progress anywhere. They're just a side quest. Pretty boring, by the way, because this game was... By now, it's pretty bit dated. But even though it's late dated, I still love some of these missions. Okay, so I think we need to go back. No, not go back. I mean, where is the med clinic? Emily Wong, isn't he... No, Emily Wong is somewhere else, oh fuck. How you... Emily Wong, yeah. Where are you? Here you are.
Word on the street is that you've been busy. Congratulations on taking down Fist. I was sure he was a big player in anything going on here. Did you find anything in his office that could help me?
These OSDs might have the information you're looking for.
You've got this files? This could be even bigger than I'd hoped. Here, Commander, for your trouble.
Let's be a hero, because she's nice to us.
What would my future cooperation be worth? Say, an interview when my investigation is over?
Exclusive? You talk to me before you talk to anyone else? That would be worth quite a bit, and I'd be very happy to compensate you accordingly. Here you are. Now, if you'll excuse me, I should go see what's on these discs.
Oh, she gave me money. More money. Money, money, money. But I feel like a jerk a little bit, because I'll give you probably a false hope. But hey, maybe I will give her my... Ah, goddammit, lagging. How long we in this video? Because it would be really stupid if it's like 40 minutes already. So yeah, we down here. Where the sea sack? So yeah, here we have elevator bay. Oh, this one. I don't remember. Wait a minute. To the docking bay. Before we go, let's check this room out, because there is a good stuff that we can fight. Oh no, it's a shop. There we can give us the most expensive stuff, yet the most deadly. And by the way, it's a really good thing to explore, because you can find a lot of different stuff. No, not with you right now. We can talk with you a little bit later. For now, let's just explore the entire room. Nothing over here. Up the stairs we go. Up the stairs we go. It's one giant ass terminal. And another keeper. Good. Wait, what? More tracking terminals. And a keeper. The more keeper you have, the better it's for the entire world. Yeah, so no missions yet. So let's go to the docking bay, because we need to continue with the story. This one? Yep, this one to the docking bay. Let's go to the Normandy, and you will be surprised how amazing is my ship, Garrus. Tali?
In other news, Exogeni Corp is still denying reports that one of their survey teams has gone missing in the Hades Gamma Cluster. When asked why communication with the survey team was suddenly cut off last week, company officials refused to comment.
As usual. Freaking assholes. Do it faster. It's a nice crew.
I've got big news for you, Shepard. Captain Anderson is stepping down as commanding officer of the Normandy. The ship is yours now.
She's quick and quiet, and you know the crew. Perfect ship for a Spectre. Free to welcome.
This isn't right. The Normandy belongs to you.
You needed your own ship. A Spectre can't answer to anyone but the Council. And it's time for me to step down.
Come clean with me, Captain. You owe me that much.
I was in your shoes 20 years ago, Shepard. They were considering me for the Spectres.
Why didn't you ever mention this?
What was I supposed to say? I could have been a Spectre, but I blew it? I failed, Commander. It's not something I'm proud of. Ask me later and I'll tell you the whole story. For now, all you need to know is, I was sent on a mission with Saren, and he made sure the Council rejected me. I had my shot. It came and went. Now you have a chance to make up for my mistakes.
You will count on, you can count on me, my dear friend.
Saren's gone. Don't even try to find him. But we know what he's after. The Conduit. He's got his Geth scouring the Traverse looking for clues.
We had reports of Geth in the Pharos system shortly before our colony there dropped out of contact, and there have been sightings around Novaria.
Find out what Saren was after on Pharos and Novaria. Maybe you can figure out where the Conduit is before he does.
What about the Reapers?
The Reapers are the real threat.
I'm with the Council on this one,
Shepard. Oh, shut up, Odina!
Even exist.
But if they do exist, the Conduit's the key to bringing them back. Stop Saren from getting the Conduit, and we stop the Reapers from returning.
I'll stop him.
Squawk!
Patriarch Benizia, the other voice in that recording? She has a daughter, a scientist who specializes in the Protheans. We don't know if she's involved, but it might be a good idea to try and find her. See what she knows. Her name's Liara, Dr. Liara Tassoni. We have reports she was exploring an archaeological dig on one of the uncharted worlds in the Artemis Tau Cluster.
I'll stop there.
Sounds like we should head for the Artemis Tau Cluster.
It's your decision, Commander. You're a Spectre now. You don't answer to us.
But your actions still reflect on humanity as a whole. You make a mess and I get stuck cleaning it up.
I'll take care of Saren. You take care of the political fallout.
Not exactly the answer I was looking for, Shepard. Remember,
shut up, your ass!
Long before you were a Spectre. I have a meeting to get to. Captain Anderson can answer any questions you might have.
He deserved it!
Yes, Commander?
How are you holding up?
Honestly, this isn't how I pictured my career coming to an end. Pushing papers really isn't my thing. But you're the one who can stop Sam. I believe in you, Shepard. If that means I have to step aside, so be it.
Tell me what happened with you and Saren 20 years ago.
It's close to 20 years ago now. Ambassador Goyle was our representative here on the Citadel. Like Udina, she wanted to get a human into the Spectres. She chose me.
And you failed.
The Council sent Saren to keep an eye on me and evaluate my performance, just like they sent Nihilus to keep tabs on you.
Why weren't you honest with me?
It's not something I'm proud of. I had a chance to become the first human Spectre, and I failed. Saren made sure of that.
I think I deserve the whole story.
We had intel on a rogue scientist being funded by Batarian interests. He was trying to set up a facility to develop illegal AI technology out in the Verge. Alliance intel had done all the work, but the Council wanted a Spectre involved. We compromised. I was assigned to help Saren in his investigation. We tracked the scientist to a refining facility on Kamala. He was hidden away somewhere inside, protected by an army of Batarian mercenaries. The plan was simple. Sneak into the plant, capture the scientist, sneak back out. Quick, quiet, and a minimum of bloodshed.
I'm guessing things didn't go as planned.
Saren and I split up to cover more ground. Then about halfway through the mission, there was a massive explosion in the refinery core. Officially, it was ruled an accident, but I think Saren detonated it on purpose to draw off the enemy guards.
How many casualties?
The explosion tore the refinery to shreds. The whole place was on fire. Black chemical clouds poured out into the atmosphere. Nobody inside survived. There was a camp for the workers and their families nearby. Between the fires and the toxic fumes, the final death count was over 500. Mostly civilians. Saren didn't care. The target was eliminated. Mission accomplished. And I ended up taking the blame.
What an asshole!
All talk of me joining the Spectres.
Saren caused the explosion. How'd he pin it on you?
In his report, Saren accused me of blowing his cover. He said it was my fault the guards were ready for us. He claimed that's why it turned into a massacre. Saren's report was all the proof the Council needed to kill my chances of becoming a Spectre.
That's not fair.
Why'd you let him get away with it?
Who do you think the Council was going to listen to? Me? Or their best agent? I had a bad feeling about him right from the start. I should have been more careful. Maybe I could have stopped things before they got out of hand.
Don't blame yourself, Captain.
I don't. I blame
Just like the... Why did you stop him, man? Don't blame yourself.
He was looking for an excuse to blow that refinery. Maybe he just likes the violence. Maybe he was just trying to make me look bad to keep humans out of the Spectres. If so, he pulled it off.
The only thing I care about is stopping Sarah.
You're right, Commander. It's no good living in the past.
Any extra intel you can give me on our colony at Pharos?
The entire planet used to be one giant Prothean city, mostly ruins now. But some of the infrastructure is still intact. The colony tried to build on what the Protheans left behind. We lost all contact with them when the Geth attacked.
What do you know about the Artemis Tau cluster?
Not much.
Taus! Then this game, crap! They're gonna bring the peace to me. No, please, go away, Taus!
Finding Dr. Tassoni. My advice is to look for the world with the Prothean ruins.
What can you tell me about Novaria?
Novaria's trouble. Always has been. The whole planet's basically a center for corporations to conduct illegal research.
As usual.
Watch your back, Lenshaw. Spectres are about the only form of Citadel authority Novaria respects. But they aren't popular.
Goodbye, my dear friend.
I should go.
I'll be here if you need me.
Why you said good? I should go? It's not...
Shepard, it's an honor to be among her crew.
Finally, somebody respects me.
Normandy combines the best of Alliance technology and Turian engineering. It shows what we're capable of if we work together.
Damn right, my dear friend.
Stand by.
Don't scan me.
Decontamination.
Don't scan me. Okay, scan me.
Happened to Captain Anderson. Survives 100 battles and then gets taken down by backroom politics. Just watch your back, Commander. Things go bad on this mission, you're next on their chopping block.
Captain Anderson should be the one in charge. It's like I'm stealing the ship from him.
Yeah, the captain got screwed. But it's not like you could have stopped it. Nobody's blaming you. Everyone on this ship's behind you, Commander. 100%.
Great.
Your comms open. You got anything you want to say to the crew? Now's the time.
I have bad suspicions, but be honest with them.
This is Commander Shepard speaking.
We have our orders. Find Saren before he finds the conduit. I won't lie to you, crew. This mission isn't going to be easy.
For too long, our species has stood apart from the others.
Now it's time for us to step up and do our part for the rest of the galaxy. Time to show them what humans are made of.
Our enemy knows we're coming.
When we go into the Traverse, Saren's followers will be waiting for us. But we'll be ready for them, too.
Humanity needs to do this.
Not just for our own sake, but for the sake of every other species in Citadel space. Saren must be stopped. And I promise you all, we will stop him.
Badass!
Said, Commander. Captain will be proud.
The captain gave up everything so I could have this chance. We can't fail.
Badass! Oh, I have just tingling all over my back. Like, oh my god, I'm a badass! I'm a freaking motherfucking badass! Pressy, did you saw that? I cannot talk with Pressy. Hey, before we go there. Is there anything here? No, it's just freaking communication room. Here it is. Let's go downstairs. Here we're gonna meet our bitch boy, as I'm a fire, as I remember. Yep, here comes a bitch boy.
Just trying to get a sense of where the crew's at. Thoughts?
I've wasted enough of your time for now, Commander. We'll have time for personal debriefings later.
What's your opinion on the last mission?
I don't see how we could have done things any better. At least not without getting to Eden Prime sooner. And we were on the scene faster than any other Alliance ship could have been.
We'll talk another time, Lieutenant.
Commander?
Age! I've got an age? Wait, is it good? Ah, fuck. I really wanted the AG.
Yes, Commander? Is there something you need?
I should go.
Goodbye, Commander.
I just like how Captain, how the Dr. Chuck was in this game. He's like really, really third background character. But in the second game, she's like become one of the most main crews of the entire group. She's still a doctor and she still sits her ass in the freaking medical bay, but still, it's still freaking better than nothing. And by the way, in the second game, she has a strong personality. Oh yes, I remember that. So here we have Talis Loka, Rex, Garrus, Kaden, and Ashley. And the first one is probably for Liara Tassoni. Fuck. I really like Tali more.
Thanks for bringing me on board, Commander. I knew working with a Spectre would be better than life at CSAC.
Have you worked with a Spectre before?
Well, no, but I know what they're like. Spectres make their own rules. You're free to handle things your way. At CSAC, you're buried by rules. The damn bureaucrats are always on your back.
Being a Spectre does have its advantages.
Exactly my point. If I'm trying to take down a suspect, it shouldn't matter how I do it, as long as I do it. But CSEC wants it done their way. Protocol and procedure come first. That's why I left.
So you just quit because you didn't like the way they do things?
There's more to it than that. It didn't start out bad, but as I rose in ranks, I got saddled with more and more red tape. CSEC's handling of Saren was typical. I just couldn't take it anymore. I hate me.
I hope you made the right choice. I'd hate for you to regret it later.
Well, that's sort of why I teamed up with you. It's a chance for me to get off the Citadel, see how things are done outside CSAC. Either way, I plan to make the most of this. And without CSAC headquarters looking over my shoulder, well, maybe I can get the job done my way for a change.
If getting the job done means endangering innocent people, then no. We get the job done right, not bad. Got it?
I wasn't trying to. I understand.
I'll be honest with him. I do not like when innocent people get hurt. Rex!
Nice ship you got, Shepard. What can I do for you?
What's your story, Rex?
There's no story.
There's only pain.
Go ask the Quarian if you want stories.
Are you freaking racist? Let's be rude to him.
You Krogan lived for centuries. Don't tell me you haven't had a few interesting adventures.
Well, there was this one time the Turians almost wiped out our entire race. That was fun.
I heard about that. You know, they almost did the same to us.
It's not the same.
It seems pretty much the same to me.
So your people were infected with a genetic mutation? An infection that makes only a few in a thousand children survive birth? And I suppose it's destroying your entire species?
I suppose it isn't all the same.
I don't expect you to understand, but don't compare humanity's fate with the Krogan.
I was just making conversation. I wasn't trying to upset you.
Your ignorance doesn't upset me, Shepard.
Oh. Oh.
As for the Krogan, I gave up on them long ago. The genophage infected us. But it's not what's killing us.
Are your people really dying?
We're sure not getting any stronger. We're too spread out. None of us are interested in staying in our own system.
Lots of species have left their homes and prospered.
But they go to colonize new worlds.
And you just can't destroy.
We're warriors. We want to fight. So we leave. Hire ourselves out, and most of us never go back.
It's actually pretty sad.
What can you tell me about the genophage?
Ask the Solarians if you want details. They made it. All I know, it makes breeding nearly impossible. Thousands die in stillbirth, and most never get that far. Every Krogan is infected. Everyone. And no one's rushing to find a cure.
Why don't the Krogan try to find a cure?
When was the last time you saw a Krogan scientist?
In second game, believe me.
You ask a Krogan. Would he rather find a cure for the genophage or fight for credits? He'll choose fighting every time. It's just who we are, Shepard. I can't change that. Nobody can.
So long, Rex.
Shepard?
Shepard.
Okay, anyway, we're out of time, sadly. In the next episode, I'm gonna continue this talk with the crew, and we go to take our new companion named Laerte Sony. Anyway, thank you for watching. I'm gonna stand on the... Here we are. I'm gonna slowly walk away from here, and I'm gonna end this episode in the most epic fashion. Thank you all for watching. I hope I'm gonna see you in the next one. But for now, bye-bye. And before that, like and subscribe in order to support me. I mix around together. I need to episode before I fucking bumped into the elevator. Awkward. Okay. Just stand here. Be all epic and... Bye-bye!